Hello everyone, welcome to Bricks and Mortar, brought to you by Business Day. My name is Ofure Ivahomu, your real estate investment consultant. On this show, you are going to be learning simple steps to take while thinking of becoming a real estate investor. And our focus today is on virgin real estate investors. What does that mean, virgin real estate investors? It means real estate investors that have not done anything like real estate investment before, but they are interested to do big time real estate investment. And it's important that you know that that choice you are about to take, it's very good, because real estate investing gives you ability to create wealth. It gives you an opportunity to live the big, beautiful lifestyle that you think you want to live. And your money is actually working for you, and it gives you the pleasure that you desire. So I'm focusing today on teaching you on how to come into becoming a real estate investor. There are 5 things that you also need to know when you have that desire. 1, you must know the markets. If you are desirous to be a real estate investor and you want to play in any markets, you must know the market. You must take time to research. You must take time to spend some time with people that are already investors, that are doing so well in the market. You must know the market. You must understand the market. You must know where to play in the market. Because if you do not know the market, then you might be making some terrible mistakes and putting your money in places that you will not get huge return. And the second thing I want you to know is that don't buy single family units. I know a lot of people will be wondering why. I'm talking to investors and I'm saying buying a single family unit is not the right choice in real estate investment. You need to buy multiple family units. In my next episode, I'm going to be talking to you and telling you the advantage that you can have when you buy multiple family units. The third thing is, don't buy based on your budget. As a real estate investor, I'm sure that you'll be thinking, she doesn't want me to buy single family units, and I have a budget. Don't think like that. Once you have made up your mind to be an investor, you must also begin to open your mind to think beyond your capacity. And that is why I'm saying that when you want to take this decision, don't buy based on your budget. Buy what you know is going to give you a lot of profit. And if you're buying something that is more than your budget, there are ways to get the money. And in another episode, I'll be teaching you on how to raise money to buy real estate investments. Don't buy less than 12 to 14 units. Buying a single family unit is a trap. It is a liability. Let me give you a scenario. If you buy 1 unit and it is vacant for 12 months, you are basically losing money. Buying 1 unit, it's 1 door, 1 trouble. So, but when you buy between 12 to 24 units, you have an opportunity to have 24 people stay in your apartments, and that can give you massive cash flow. I know you'll be thinking, do you know how much it's going to cost me to buy 12 to 14 units? First of all, make up your mind that you want to play in only multiple family units, because sometimes the money that you're going to use to buy 1 single family residence can actually buy you 5 family units, 5 multiple family units. So it depends on where you want to invest your money. So you need to talk to some experts. They'll be able to guide you. Then the 5th thing I'm going to be talking about is, you need to have a good real estate manager. I tell a lot of people, when you want to have a real estate manager is different from a real estate broker. Like somebody will say, brokers are broke. A real estate manager that is also a real estate investor, He can tell you the places you should play. He can tell you the areas you should go to. He can tell you how to create an opportunity in the real estate market. Most importantly, he can teach you on the problems that your money can actually solve. Like I will always say, that if you want to make it big in the real estate space, you must be solving a problem. Because success comes when you look out for a problem and reach out to meet that problem. When you solve that problem, money will, of necessity, gravitate towards your bank account. So as an angel investor or as a virgin investor, it is important that you know the market. It is important that you don't buy single family units. It's also important that you don't buy based on your budget and don't buy less than 12 to 24 units. And get a good real estate consultant that can guide you through this. I know you have learned a lot from this topic. Thank you so much for listening to us. Until I come your way again next week, please do follow us on all our social media handle @businessdayng.